Do you want your material design inspired animation to be buttery smooth on the user's wrist? And having the bonus of being power efficient as well? I'm Hoi Lam. With a few simple but not always obvious tricks, you can make your apps run smoothly without straining the battery. Let's take a look. One of the most important considerations is the manipulation of large bitmaps. It is an expensive operation, and you can save hugely by resizing bitmaps to what is needed for your screen and crop the invisible or transparent pixels out. For example, in the center watch face we published during the 2014 holidays, we removed the transparent areas around center's hand. This reduced bitmap size by 97% and increased frame rate by 56%. The reason for this performance gain is that on some device, bitmaps are software rasterized. Getting rid of transparent pixels greatly reduces the amount of work, which of course increases performance. Second, if you have a complex and static graphical element, make sure that you only draw it once. For example, take my colleague's open source project, the Ultima Stopwatch. Drawing all the elements of the watch face in every frame would have cost about 100 to 150 milliseconds per frame. If you do the math, that's only about 10 frames per second. So instead of redrawing the watch face in every frame, the app draws it once and saves it. When it redraws a frame, it can load the saved watch face and draw the hand on top of it. So how do we implement this? Well, there are two ways. The first applies to general application with a view hierarchy. The second relates to the specific case of the watch face, which do not have a view hierarchy. For applications, you can refactor the static background into a separate custom view and set its layer type to hardware. For this type of view, the onDraw method will only be called once when the view is first shown. Remember, this should only be done for complex shapes. If the app just needs to draw a bitmap, separating this into another layer will not improve performance. For watch faces which do not have a view hierarchy and are not hardware accelerated, override the onSizeChange method in the watch face engine. Initiate your background object, connect it to a canvas object, and draw on that. Whatever you draw on this canvas will automatically be saved to the background bitmap. Of course, like all things in computer science, there are trade-offs. In the case of off-screen canvas rendering, there are two. First, we need to ask whether this is actually faster than just drawing the image. In the case of the Ultima Stopwatch, the answer is yes. For simpler design, the answer may be no. Luckily, there is a simple way to help you make the correct decision. You can use the Android device monitor to see how your application or watch face is running. In Android Studio, go to Tools, Android, and then Android device monitor, and select the device you want to profile. Generate a report by clicking on the Sys Trace button. When prompted, select three items, graphics, view hierarchy, and CPU scheduling in your report. You can count the number of service flinger events per second during the sampling period and obtain the frame rate. Second, we need to consider the classic memory and processing trade-off. Hardware accelerator layers take up video memory. For watch faces, the pre-drawn bitmap requires up to 200 kilobytes of memory. For the Ultima Stopwatch, we made the conscious decision to trade memory for performance, because the processing time for each frame was simply too long. Another technique that can save you pixel is to consider whether two layers can be combined without impacting the visuals. For example, with the center watch face, we combined the blue sky with the minute mark around the edges, resulting in a 39% gain in frame rate. Remember, when it comes to rendering, less is more. Because the fewer pixels you're processing, the better your frame rates will be. Last but not least, how should developers implement animations? Here are two sets of advice, one for general application, the other for watch faces. For general application, you should use the property or view animation framework. This enables the system to help determine the most optimal frame rate for your animation. For watch faces, since it does not have a view hierarchy, the recommendation is slightly different. Your aim should be to make your animation code run as fast and as efficient as possible. For fluid animation on AndroidWare, aim for 30 frames per second, but more is better. In addition, please consider if having 1 frame per second or 1 frame per minute rather than full animation will be sufficient, as this will allow the processor to sleep, saving significant battery power. To implement this, use a handler which sends a delay message at set period and trigger an update. For a detailed example, please refer to the analog watch face example. At the end of the day, it's important to realize that Androidware is based on Android. As a result, many optimization tips which works on Android also applies to Androidware. There are a lot of performance best practices and tips that you should know about, so check out the rest of the Android performance pattern videos. Also, join the G+ community for Androidware and Android performance patterns for more updates. I'm Hoi Lam, and thanks for watching. Androidware is for people on the move, so let's keep those pixels moving. And remember, perf matters.